Mike's Daily Podcast.
Episode 1462. Yes, I've done 1463, rather. 1463 episodes. Episodes. Here we are at the last place on Earth, Cafe Anyway, located somewhere in Podcastro Valley, Mont. I bring the show to you daily, and I do it so that to get you caught up and to bring you a little
Mike's Daily Podcast.
A little trip to a nice little restaurant here at Cafe Anyway, where today we will hear from Shelly Shuhart, Floyd the Floorman, John Deere the Engineer.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
And a new character named Floomba. So yesterday I went to a place called Trader Joe's. It's in the Bay Area in California and parts of, I don't know, who knows. But I went there and bought some fruit for my important diet that I can dance around and start a riot, stay healthy, that kind of thing. But
Mike's Daily Podcast.
I noticed in the middle of the store a woman with her tiny little child, probably
Mike's,
I guess, two.
Daily.
The Terrible Twos.
Podcast.
Is that the age where they do their little,
yeah,
tantrum all the time? When they're yelling things like,
no! God, please, no! No! No!
That's a tantrum that they do, right? Yeah, so there's this little this kid's doing the tantrum on the floor, and the mom is just letting the kid do the tantrum on the floor, and the kid's just screaming and whatever. Oh, look who just walked in.
Hello, my God, he's a Shelly Shuhart, the chef supervisor. What an interesting excursion to Trader Joe's.
That's right, Shelly, it was. And I think kids are fascinating. I don't have any, but I do know this. All children are born with senses of humor. And when you walk up to a child that's laying on the ground, you go, hey, kind of go, wow, that's interesting what you're doing. And the child looked at me kind of, huh, what? So I think children have senses of humor. I think dogs have senses of humor. And that's why we need to learn from them. Okay. Someone else walked in.
Oh, Mike, this is Floyd the Floorman.
And this is John Deere the Engineer. Meet our new friend. It's Floomba.
Floomba? Hi, Floomba.
Hello, Mike Matthews. I am here, Floomba. I am to clean the floor for Floor the Floorman.
And here's today's podcast picture.
My name's Floyd the Floorman.
Yes, I am cleaning it now for you.
Wow, that's fascinating. Well, the podcast picture today, Floomba, everybody. Floomba. Anybody? No? Nothing? Okay. Here at Cafe Anyway. Hey, have you noticed something new other than the fact that the podcast picture sounder played and I haven't told you what the podcast picture is yet? That there's no piano playing. Usually there's piano playing right here, and that's usually me playing the piano for you at Cafe Anyway. I'm your entertainment. My name is Mike, and this is Mike's Daily Podcast. Well, I played my show for someone that I work with named Craig Roberts, who I'm going to have on the show someday. And he was like, you know, you've got that piano playing in the background. It's like distracting. And I said, it is? Kind of like a guy who like has forgotten how to cut his nose hairs. And so he walks around with this forest sticking out of his nose. And people finally come up to him and go, you know, you've got nose hairs sticking out of your face. I do? What? Hey, how about this? It's a podcast picture from Monterey. Since we're sort of in that Monterey Peninsula mode, the last podcast picture had Pacific Grove. So these are some kayakers just outside of, I want to say, is that? No, I don't know what that restaurant is. Somewhere there in the Cannery Row area. And it was a beautiful day. This was back in September after my Florida trip. And you can see that picture now at mikesdailypodcast.com. Craig also didn't seem to understand the whole podcast picture thing. And I do have to say, whenever I talk about the podcast picture, that you can see it at my Instagram, at my website, mikesdailypodcast.com. And Instagram, by the way, I am found at mikesdailypodcast.com on Instagram. Or all the other links you can find at mikesdailypodcast.com. as well as the Amazon link. Click on that and buy whatever it is you're going to buy, and that helps us out. There's also a PayPal. You can help us out that way. Get a special greeting from all the Cafe Anyway characters, maybe even Flumba, even though that character went over like a Led Zeppelin, like a lead balloon. And that was the name Led Zeppelin came from, that somebody said, hey, this band is awful. It's going to go over like a Led Zeppelin. And well, we know the end of that story, don't we? So this lady's kid screaming on the floor of Trader Joe's. I just sort of walk by and, you know, I'm not criticizing this lady or anything. Then I'm getting into the line to check out of Trader Joe's. First off, Trader Joe's doesn't really clearly mark which line is your express lane. They don't have like big flashing lights or anything. All they have are hand-drawn signs. So I'm standing in the express lane. I didn't know that. And I had like 6 bags of apples. I told you I like fruit. And all these bananas and whatnot. And so this lady, who apparently has no freaking mercy in her soul at all, said, sir, and this is at the time, and I've waited in line, and now I'm at her cash register, and then she's telling me at that moment, sir, I can't check you out because you have too many items. This is the express lane. What a jerk. Anyway, so I go to the cafe anyway. I go to the next line over, and anyway.
Anyway.
I wait again. And while I'm waiting, the lady with the kid, and this lady, by the way, probably maybe in her mid to late 20s. She's very young, young girl. And she's got her screaming young daughter, 2-year-old daughter. And the kid is still screaming and on the floor, and the woman can't do anything. She tries to pick up the daughter, and the daughter's screaming. So she puts her back on the floor. I don't understand the whole floor thing. You probably don't want your child on the floor, I would imagine. I know my mom tried to keep me off the floor as much as possible, and this was back in the 70s, where, I don't know, you would light your child... my mom would light her cigarettes, and she'd be talking, and she'd accidentally burn me. That's how my childhood went. I got burned by my mom. But I don't think that was probably the best parenting skills this woman was doing. And the kid's screaming and everybody's kind of going, ugh. So I'm trying to get out of that Trader Joe's as fast as possible. So I finally do. And I'm in my car and I'm driving. And I notice the lady has gotten into her car with her screaming child. And at this point, the child is falling asleep in the safety chair in the back. And I'm pulling out of this Fremont shopping plaza place with the Trader Joe's in it. The hub, so as it's called, the hub, hubba hubba. And as I'm leaving, I see she's behind me, and all of a sudden, she starts to cry. Tears flowing down her. I'm thinking, oh, I feel so bad for criticizing her. I feel so bad for any thoughts I may have felt that were negative towards her. And she's crying, and it's just, she's overwhelmed, this woman. So I felt so bad, and I guess that kind of lends itself into how we judge other people. The end. That was my little... Did you like it? That was my little rant on how we shouldn't be so judgmental. Okay. I have to say that Steve Bannon is a big, fat, bloated piece of crap. Oh, wait, did I say I was not going to be judgmental? Okay, Steve Bannon said this sort of thing.
The rest of them all talk like I do, behind closed doors. So, all of you folks that are so concerned that you're going to get primaried and defeated, you know, there's time for mea culpa. You can come to a stick and condemn Senator Corker.
Come to a stick? What does he mean by...
You can come to a stick, a microphone, and you can say, I am not going to vote for Mitch McConnell for majority.
Oh, so he was talking about Corker, and I don't have time to find it in the speech, but he said about Corker that how dare he criticize Trump when he's the commander-in-chief and he's leading the troops into battle, into harm's way. What the hell? He pulls that out. And how did he feel about Obama when he was president? that he criticized Obama with his stupid Breitbart news every chance he could. And he was our commander-in-chief and leading our troops into battle and into harm's way. So, frick him. But Steve
Bannon. Dirty leader.
So he hates Mitch McConnell and Corker.
And he can come to a stick. And you can say, I'm going to do away with the filibuster so the president can implement his program.
Oh, look at these idiots standing up. This was at the Values Voter Summit.
Now, Senator Barrasso and Senator Fisher and Senator Heller. And
I don't know who those people are. Okay. The other interesting news today is, as we bring you this daily show and we talk about daily things, and that's an interesting old picture of a hippie woman from what is... I'm not going to click on that hippie woman picture from like the 1960s. You can't make me, dang you clickbait. So this was definitely Associated Press reported on this. The North Korea's deputy UN ambassador warned yesterday that the situation on the Korean Peninsula has reached the touch and go point and a nuclear war may break out at any moment. Not that that seems a little extreme, but Kim In-ryong is his name. He told the UN General Assembly's Disarmament Committee that North Korea is the only country in the world that has been subjected to, quote, such an extreme and direct nuclear threat from the U.S. since the 70s. So making a comment about Trump and his tough rhetoric against Kim Jong-un, definitely Trump trying to do something that Obama wasn't doing and saying things like,
they will be met with fire, fury, and frankly power, the likes of which this world has never seen before.
He pointed to large-scale military exercises every year using nuclear assets and said what is more dangerous is what he called a U.S. plan to stage a secret operation aimed at the removal of our supreme leadership. Okay. The entire U.S. mainland is within our firing range. Oh, this is what, let's see, this year Kim said North Korea completed its state nuclear force and thus became the full-fledged nuclear. So, I don't know how much you can put behind this guy, but apparently the Associated Press thought he was worthy of note. But that could be clickbait. Back to Puerto Rico. Oh, Puerto Rico. Still, their power, the amount of power that is up in that country is below 20%. Hurricane Maria swept away the bridge that led in and out of Charco Obajo. It's a remote village in the mountainous inland of Puerto Rico. Carlos Ocasio and Pablo Perez Medina decided they could not wait for help to arrive. When the wind and rain calmed, the welder and the retired handyman climbed off the edge of the bridge, jumped down into a pile of debris. They crossed the Vivi River, whose waters had risen to their chests. They walked several miles to a hardware store, where they bought a cable, a metal harness, and wheels, and they built a pulley that now spans the gap where the bridge once was, attached to a shopping cart. After removing its legs and wheels, which they had been using to transfer food, water, and supplies across the divide. Though aid groups began to arrive a week later, the two men, both 60 years old, raised a sign to describe how it felt in Charco Obajo immediately after the storm. It reads, Campamento de los Olvidados, Spanish for Camp of the Forgotten. So, as the British say, needs must, or as we say here, mother is the necessity of invention. Is that it? Or mother necessity is the something of invention. I can't think of it at the moment. Perhaps you can think of it. You can call me 336-MM-DAILY. That's 336-MM-DAILY. And tell me, too, how you like that I don't have... I'm not playing the piano anymore in this part of the show. So that's what's going on in Puerto Rico since Trump is saying, it was messed up before the hurricane. Yeah, who cares? And now Hillary Clinton and I have another thing to bond on, and that is that we have our feet hurt really bad. Our one foot, I had to go have my foot in a boot. You can, and I sounded Canadian there, a foot in a boot. But yes, the foot was in a boot. In fact, there was a podcast that I named Boot recently because of that. It's feeling a lot better, thank you. But Hillary Clinton fell and broke her toe during her book tour in London. As President Trump said, he hoped she would run for president in 2020. Clinton, who had to cancel several interviews on Monday, appeared on the Graham Norton show with a protective walking boot on her left foot. Graham Norton is on fire right now, and BBC America is totally pushing his show left and right, and my YouTube feed is full of Graham Norton stuff. That show's a little too red. It's got the color red everywhere, but it has some really funny parts. The best thing about that show is Graham gets these American actors mixing with British actors, and sometimes like Taylor Swift couldn't understand what anybody was saying because they were speaking with their thick British accents, and you get some interesting stuff happening. So that's the Graham Norton show. And Hillary said, I was running down the stairs in heels with a cup of coffee in hand, and I was talking over my shoulder and my heel caught and I fell backwards. I will have to watch that. And yes, your Wi-Fi router is easily hacked, but no, you should not panic. According to NBC News, thanks to a newly discovered security flaw, your home Wi-Fi is completely hackable, giving cyber thieves a front row seat to everything from your private chats to your baby monitor. And there's not much you can do about it yet. Chief data scientist at Rapid7, a security data and analyst company, said, when I woke up this morning and saw this one, I was taken aback. We try to make sure if something is talked about in a bad way, it actually is bad. Called Crack, the attack takes advantage of the four-way handshake, a process between a device and a router that has been around for 14 years and designed to deliver a fresh encrypted session every time you get online. During the third step in the process, hackers can resend a key in such a way that it resets the encryption key to zero. Encryption is the process that makes your data uncrackable to anyone who might intercept it. With an unencrypted session, hackers are then free to pry on whatever you and your devices are doing on Wi-Fi. The one saving grace is the attackers need to be within range of your Wi-Fi network. So you can see them in that black van out in front of your house and go, ah, who's that? And go over and bang on the door. Dump, dump, dump. Hey, who is this? It is I, Floomba. Get out of here. Okay. And then you're done. And everything is fine. But someone can sit outside your office or the apartment next door and do this attack from there, is what this guy said. Hey, here's a thought. Get a brand new router. You know, when I got my Comcast, who I hate, I had to get I rent a router from them, basically, for $10 a month, which is ridiculous. I should just buy the thing. But that's part of the cable bill I get every month. And that thing is pretty new and should be all up to date with everything. But as we go outside a cafe anyway, we're bringing you Mike's Daily Podcast somewhere in Podcaster Valley. Next show, it is going to be Benita, the disgruntled fiddle player, and the brewmaster. No more Floomba. I think today was the one and only appearance of Floomba. Sorry, Floomba.
That is all right. I hate this place anyway.
You know, I think the show worked without the piano. Maybe not, but... don't be judgmental. Love everyone the same. You're unique just like everyone else. And have a great day. Talk to you soon.
Mike's Daily Podcast is written and produced and performed by Mike Matthews. His podcast is super easy to find. Download or listen to his show and read his blog at mikesdailypodcast.com.
Email Mike now at mikesdailypodcast@gmail.com.
See you tomorrow. Bye.